When you plan to use the Mirai robot control system for an automation task, it is important to take time to really understand the task you want the robot to perform. Understanding the task will lead to a more successful training. Training is the phase when the Mirai-powered robot, based on your hand-guided demonstrations, learns to perform the task on its own. We show training in a separate video. By task, we mean an automatized action that a robot executes. For instance, a task may be insert a cable into an outlet or move the beaker from this tray to that tray. There are 5 steps to understanding a task. 1. Examine the current state of the task and the environment. 2. Identify the challenge. 3. Assess the sources of variance. 4. Identify native controlled motions and Mirai controlled motions. 5. Decide which degrees of freedom are needed. Let's go through these steps. We recommend taking notes. Step 1. Examine the current state of the task and the environment. This is where you ask yourself a fundamental question. What tasks do you want the robot to do? If a human currently does the task, be it an assembly task or quality inspection task, you want to observe how they do it. This person has naturally fine-tuned their movements. Like that person, the robot should use the shortest path with no extra movements. Let me show you here. In this first step, take note of the environment. Are you in a factory setting, a lab? Do you have consistent artificial light? Or do windows allow in variable natural light? Here in our lab, natural light streams in through large windows on either side of the office. Because we're in Berlin, the sun sets at 9:30 p.m. in June, but at 4 p.m. in December. If our task is to move these beakers from this tray to that tray, we need to account for the changing light conditions during the training. Likewise, observe the workspace surroundings. Would there be dust in the air? Would nearby surfaces be oily or reflective? These are all critical variables to document, because through this camera, Mirai will record all of these visuals during training. Step 2. Identify the challenge in your task. Ask yourself, what is the technical reason that the task at hand has not been automated already? This is the challenge. If our task is to move these beakers from this tray to that tray, we actually have 2 challenges. 1, picking up the beaker is tricky, especially if the tray isn't in the exact same place every time the robot approaches. The positions of the beakers vary. Let me show you here. You see that the position of the tray can vary, and therefore also the position of the beaker, meaning the beaker is not at the exact same position every time the robot is approaching. And this is normal for workpieces delivered in a factory setting. Because a standard robot is essentially blind, it can't see what things are. As a result, it can't cope with the variance. Not only that, the color of the liquid inside isn't always the same either. Just like here, where you see the liquid in this beaker, for example, is blue. This means that an automation solution with the vision system would also have a hard time making sense of the scene. As you may have realized, identifying challenges is closely related to the concept of variance, which brings us to step 3, assess the sources of variance. Automation tasks get complex when workspace conditions or workpiece properties are unpredictable. This is variance. Classic automation solutions are either unable to deal with variance or they're extremely expensive to set up. A typical source of variance is the target object, like these beakers. How might the target object change every time the robot approaches? Are the target objects always the same, or do they differ in size, shape, or in this case, color? Another source of variance, the object in the gripper. When held by the gripper, can it shift? Let me show you what I mean. Let me close the gripper. So can it move inside of the gripper? The background can also be a source of variance. Behind your workspace are there moving objects, changing monitor displays, people, vehicles, or other robots? Then there are light conditions. Would they change throughout the day, throughout the year? You should document the sources of variance in your task. Step 4. Identify native controlled motions and MIRAI controlled motions. Imagine the whole task you want the robot to perform and then split that task into sections. The robot's native controller will direct some sections. Other sections, the MIRAI controller system will control. We use the AI-powered MIRAI system for the complex sections with variance because the native robot controller can't handle these. For each complex section, we want the robot to perform within the broader task, we train a MIRAI skill. A MIRAI skill is an ability of a robot to perform a movement that involves variance. A MIRAI skill is acquired through human demonstrated training. In our case here, there are three sections. The native controller positions the robot above the glass beaker, which is step one. But now imagine there's variance. Now MIRAI skill kicks in to cope with that variance. As the next step, the beaker is picked by the native robot controller and moved and inserted into the other tray. Finally, decide which degrees of freedom are needed. Degrees of freedom refer to the defined movements that the robot can perform in free space. The position of an object can be changed by moving it up, down, left, right, forward, and backward. We call this translations. Let me show you. So you see it here, up and down. Additionally, you can also change the orientation of the object by rotating it around the X, Y, and or Z axis. Let me show you. Here you see the different kinds of rotations here around the Z axis. Altogether, you have 6 degrees of freedom, 3 translational and 3 rotational. You should assess how many degrees of freedom you need for your task. You want to minimize the degrees of freedom. The less degrees of freedom you use, the more efficient your task becomes. Note down which degrees of freedom are needed. This information will be necessary later. Get in touch if you need support with the degrees of freedom question. To recap, there are 5 steps to understanding a task. 1, examine the current state of the task in the production environment. 2, identify the challenge. 3, assess the sources of variance. 4, identify native controlled motions and MIRAI controlled motions. 5, decide which degrees of freedoms are needed. Thanks for your time.